All right. Welcome to episode 25 of Renaissance of the Antiquities. Last week, when we played last, and some of the prior events leading up to that, the group had finally found and entered the anchor in the center of Silver Lake, going through this large geode broken apart with a portal spilling out seawater. They rode inside to find an isolated and abandoned city inside of some sort of dome made of some white material. You all ventured through it, and as you ventured with Sin and explored, he talked a little bit about this place, that it's made of something called White Astron, and that has something to do with some sort of titanic form him and others of his kind used to inhabit. But the Vith, with the help of the dwarves, helped construct this place long, long ago. He knew there was some sort of temple he needed to get back to, so that he could connect to this place and discover what was wrong with it, and why it was causing this massive storm outside of Silver Lake, in addition to other strange effects that had been happening in the area. He found the temple, fought a massive amount of these ice-like crabs that nearly tore you all apart, but you managed to survive with your wits and your wonderful healer, RJ. You rested within the temple, finding a safe room in what must have once been the bedchambers of some former priest or Vith from long ago. Set up a trap to make sure you were safe. And the night, Nithyrn connected with the spirits of this place by happenstance when she tried to connect into the dream realm. She had learned that the waters of this place would need to be made holy again if they were to aid in delving into the further reaches of this chamber. Having informed Sin of that, he understood what they meant and went to a pool of water that was within the temple, where he started a ritual and had the apparitions appear before you all, where they wanted your testimony as to why you followed Sin to this place, why he should be forgiven, and what motivates you all. Through a varying amount of stories between you all, you seem to, for the most part, persuade the entities. And in a final act of power, a miracle, Sin made the spirit of Noth appear and gave him the choice to choose his freedom or fate in the afterlife. Noth chose to stay with Tawin, and his spiritual form entered into Tawin's. What that means and where that's to lead is yet to take manifestation. But with that, you're able to enter into the deeper reaches of the temple, where among a puzzle and a cloak that you found and a few other treasures, you found the altar that Sin needed to connect with. And before quite connecting with him there, or letting him connect with it there, you first had a infiltrator to suss out in the form of Willy, who turned out to not be Willy, but Linenia herself, having followed you in under his guise for whatever her reasons may have been. There was a quite a bit of a long discussion with Linenia about what she intends to do, what her motivations are, and where she stands in relation to this information of not only the anchor, but towards you guys as a whole. Overall, she seems to want the same things as you, to fix the anchor and to ensure that the future of this place is secured in some way. How that's to be done, however, is still up for debate as to whether the Vith are to do that undertaking, the dwarves, or perhaps some sort of coalition of both. In any case, you set that discussion aside, as there's nothing that could be done for it here now, and decided to get back with Sin, have him connect and discover what was truly wrong with this place, and see what you could all do about it. Sin connected a growth of white astron forming around his body, and you heard his voice in your minds that there was some sort of massive creature outside this place trying to crush it beneath its grasp. And that there, while a lot of the damage he was able to reverse, there were still some places where this form, this thing, had intruded and pierced through, and that he would not be able to fully protect this place while those still existed. So, together, you all rushed off across the town. Only a mile or so in diameter, it didn't take long, although you were minorly slowed when you got to the flooded sections of this place, where water was up to your knees and ankles, for some, RJ, up to your waist, and if not a little higher. Seeing the massive tentacles along the side of the dome's wall itself, you stopped a little bit of a distance off, in the hopes to gain higher ground and get out of the water by climbing up to the top of the various buildings around you. In the middle of that, however, it seems some other form of attack started to dissuade you from that, as multiple water elementals assaulted the group, creating vortexes beneath your feet and preventing everyone from gaining up into the buildings themselves. A fight broke out against the water elementals, and Linania split off, going across the way and lobbing fireballs at the base of the tentacles in an attempt to detach them from the wall so that it may be healed. In between that, you alerted the attention of the tentacles themselves, who turned and started swinging and slashing and bashing at all of you, trying to grab you, knock you back, pick you up, drown you, anything they could do. Although you guys kept a fairly defensible front and were not dissuaded too much by them, even damaging a couple of them enough to the point where they could not retaliate much in their current moment. That gave enough time for Linenia, and enough of a distraction for her, to fire off enough fireballs to detach the things from the wall. And then there was a moment of calm. The water elementals dealt with, the tentacles blasted from the sides of the walls, until the tentacles themselves started to coalesce and recombine together in this twisting, horrid form that you see here. Multiple eyes and a jagged toothed maw appeared before you as this thing rises from the waters only 40 or so feet off from you guys. At least for those who are still on the ground and in the water. And it is here that we left off. So, to start us off again this session, let's go ahead and get that initiative.
Question, was there time between the point that we finished the first combat and this happened?
Yes, there was roughly 1 minute that elapsed.
Okay, I went and got the weapon.
Okay. Consider that... Nope. There was about a minute amount of time where the tentacles wriggled and writhed to come to one another. So for anybody who has anything that's time-based, 1 minute has elapsed since the fight with the tentacles and the water elementals.
Okay, and is there a way to... No character on it? Okay, no, just...
Yeah, no, I don't have a battle map.
Okay.
The only thing that matters about me is my range, but I can just take that away as a free action and then put it back on.
Yep, it dropped off. But additionally, it also...
Yeah.
The debuff that comes with that has also fallen off.
Somebody rolled a crit! Chris Rune!
Yep.
Damn, guys. You guys are rolling pretty high.
Mine's a 7. The first one. It double clicked.
Ah. So it has.
And When you're ready to start us, can you give us some sort of a layout, just to kind of get us an idea of distances?
Yes. Similar to last time, where Nithyrn and Tawin, you were down in the water, close to the edges of the buildings themselves. RJ and Fizz were on top of the buildings, and Wizard was peeking out of an alleyway some 20 or so feet behind the front line. This thing, in relation to Tawin and Nithyrn, who are kind of up front near the building, is about 40 feet down the roadway in between the buildings.
Sounds good.
All right, and with that, you see this thing coalesce and rear up and give a ear-shattering roar that echoes across the dome.
How far away from me is it?
From you, it's probably about 60 feet, because you had moved back a bit on top of the rooftops themselves.
Yeah.
Although, if you wanted to be a bit closer, you could, because you had the time. Or further.
No, I'm good with 60 feet.
I don't know if you would allow me this, Nuvar, but maybe in that 1 minute, I will drink in a health potion.
Yep.
For vigor.
Yep.
That would have been my one thing, because...
Yep, anything else anybody else would have done in that 1 minute as Fizz gets his first turn moving off here.
I toss Aween a potion of enlarge.
I already have one, but I'll take a second one. I have a second enlarge, and I just used a cure light. 1d8 plus. What is that for you? You made this, RJ. What is that?
It'll be 1d8 plus 4.
Plus 4?
I think I made it plus when I made it, though.
Plus
4 is fine.
excellent. 15. No, why the fuck did I say 15?
11.
That's still good. Still good. I'm good.
Alright. Fizz, what you got for us?
Okay. I'm going to cast Glitter Dust on him.
Alrighty.
So will save to negate. DC is 15.
Succeed.
25! But, so he's not blind.
He is not hiding.
Hide.
He is certainly not hiding at all.
It's worth a try.
And are you keeping the 60-foot distance?
Yes, I am keeping the 60-foot distance.
All right. Wizrune. Gonna peek out from his alleyway and do what he does best. Oh, boy. The 12 will hit for 1 damage. however...
You just do himself.
However, let me get that open. I should have had that open, because it always happens. Let's see, a good old spell fumble. Ha 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 ha! The spell is converted into a summon monster spell of the same level that attacks you. It's not gonna be.
Oh boy.
But Ray of Frost is a level 0 spell?
Indeed.
Yeah.
So, what is he attacking?
I would say, because I don't think there is a 0 level summon.
There is not.
So, maybe reroll.
Yeah, there is.
The...
Yes, there is. Yes, there is.
Zero summon level minion?
No, summon.
Yeah, summon
it's
minion.
The same thing.
Oh, no, that's first level spell.
No, there's a 0 level. I use it all the time.
What's it called?
Hang on.
Oh yeah, he summons snake. His snake train.
Summon nature's ally.
That's a different spell.
Yeah.
Hang on. I get it. It's called summon nature's minor ally. There you go. I dropped it in there. It's a bat, a cat, a lizard, a rat, a raven, a tiny viper, toad, or weasel. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Get a toad
7,
to attack
eight.
Him.
Roll
I mean...
a 1d8. There you go. Number 2, that is
excellent.
A
hostile cat is summoned on a windowsill next to Wizrin.
And it's pissed at him.
He's just going to have his own fight with a cat now.
And,
does it last? If it only lasts by his level, then it's only going to be around for...
It doesn't specify. So there's
well,
just a cat
okay.
now.
It's summoned,
keeping
so...
that cat.
There is now a hostile cat.
Yeah,
excellent.
One round per level, but...
That's...
I'm just giving you information.
The cat jumps down off the windowsill onto Wizard's shoulder, clawing at him viciously. Where this cat has come from, who knows? Why it is so pissed, who knows? But it starts to tear him asunder.
Well, clearly it was on the plane of cats, and it is now no longer at home.
And Mizrin takes 2 damage, because that's minimum 1.
So Mizrin just fucking summons a cat, and he just instantly attacks.
It just goes ham on him, yep. You just hear in the background, in the distance, just... And Mizrin goes, oh, kill him! Get off of him! From the alleyway behind. Reginald, it is your turn!
Reginald is too busy noticing the giant tentacle monster.
Probably a good call.
Yeah. He throws one of his 4 remaining bombs.
From what distance?
At the edge of a roof I'm on. Or close to that, I'll get me to it.
You could get about 30 feet away from the corner of the roof that you're on. You could jump to the next roof if you wanted to attempt that. And then you could get within 20, and that would all be within one movement. But that would require an acrobatics.
I'll try the acrobatics.
All right. That's fine. There's DC 5. It's not that big of a jump. You jump across and get within 20 feet. You're also above it, so you get a +1 to attack rolls. Height advantage.
That show up for you?
Nope.
No.
Heard the beep-a-da-boop, but no, nothing showed up.
I think...
Acrobats? Oh no, there's an 8.
Did you, like, whisper it?
No.
Through the bomb. It's clicking the, peeping what the dice beside it.
You might have /GM instead of /EM in front of it.
Nope, I set it up so everything's public. On the sheets.
Like that.
Yeah, I'm hearing it, but I'm not seeing it.
Yeah, that is weird.
But it's rolling. There's nothing there, though. It's rolling empty.
All my items.
All my attacks are rolling empty.
You know what? That's because that's probably because those were carried over attacks. You'll probably have to recreate your attacks. But for now, just go ahead and roll the d20 and put with the bonus and do it manually.
Alright.
I didn't even think about that when the sheets got transitioned.
Yeah. I just refreshed my page to see if that made a difference, and it did not.
No, it's the macro inherently in itself. It probably isn't connected correctly.
3+4.
Yep, everybody's gonna have that problem.
+4. 1 8, I think.
You should see the attack bonus right there in the macro still.
Yeah.
You might be able to just click, like, range attack in the
That's true.
Section.
Yep. That's versus touch, correct?
Versus touch.
Okay, that'll hit.
Well, please versus touch.
Yep.
D6. 4. Southern fire damage.
Alright, the bomb flies across the air and splashes across the creature's form. It writhes a bit and seems even more pissed. Nithir, and that brings it to you.
One second. Alright, I'm gonna have the same problem with macros. Alright, so what size is this?
Large.
Large? What I think its reach is? Do I have any estimation?
I mean, it's got lots of tentacles. Could be more than a large creature character. Could be like a large creature.
Hard to say. It's got big old long arms that looks like it can reach out, or...
Yep.
You know, okay. Yep. And how many arms does it appear to have?
A dozen or so. But how many of those actually functionally attack? You're not sure, if any.
Yeah. And nobody's in range right now. Okay, so I am going to... And how far away am I?
You are 40 feet away.
Okay,
and it's all difficult terrain between you and it.
I could charge through. I can move through difficult terrain, I think, but if I want to. I just realized that when I was going over my things. Something I've not been doing. Man, I don't know what to do with this thing. I will, first round I'm going to go full defense. Got my weapon out, defensive weapon, and go in total defense, just for now. Until I figure out what I'm going to do.
Alrighty.
Continue.
It's turn. It, not too pleased about the bomb that was just launched onto it. Some of its tentacles, it lowers itself slightly into the water, and it just jets itself forward. And at the base of the building that RJ is at, which is a bit before Nithirin and Taween even, as it meets the end of the wall, other of the tentacles slap up and grab onto the wall, almost as one fluid movement as it transitions from skating across the water to scaling the side of the building. And it hangs there, grabbed on by four or five of its tentacles on the side of the building as it pulls its jaw straight up to you, to Reginald. And it is going to come in for a bite.
Okay.
Yeah. 23 versus AC.
That's all the other misses.
So it's 23 versus AC. The 7 bludgeoning, piercing, slashing damage. Okay. The other is a grapple. So that 19 is versus CMD.
CMD?
Correct.
This CMD. I'm grappled.
And if it succeeds a grapple check, it automatically gets its constrict damage. So 17, or 10 more damage for 17 total. As it slams and climbs up the side of this building fluidly, reaches up, snaps the gnome into its mouth, and then lets go and falls back into the water itself at the base of the building with RJ in its jaw. Bringing it to Tywin.
Alright, Tywin. So, how far is it away from me now?
It is 20 feet away from you at this point, through difficult terrain.
So I take my full...
I can make that macro look a lot cleaner.
Hurting this damn thing. Alright. Reaction rage. Blood rage. Let's start that at least.
Yep.
And then I'm going to do standard action, drink an enlarged person potion. I would have taken the RJ giving me an extra one as drink this now. So I will drink an enlarged person making me large now. I'll hit that buff now. And then I will move. I don't even have to move my. Now I have a reach up. Now I have a fucking. I have a reach of 10 now. Or 15. Oh, it's.
Reach of
10, but I can attack from 3 squares out.
Yep.
I'm going to move within my attack range of it.
Yep.
And that will be my turn.
All right. Back at the top of initiative with Fizz.
Yes.
It's now about 40 feet from you.
40 feet from me.
Beginning to slap RJ around in its jaws like a chew toy.
I will move 10 feet or 5 feet closer so that I'm just within range. And I will try and cast Grease specifically on RJ.
Ah, okay.
So you for 4 minutes provided, I mean,
yeah, he gets a plus 10 on escape artist and CMB checks.
Yeah.
Excellent.
And that is my turn.
A wonderful use of that spell.
Agreed.
Was gonna cast it on myself, but didn't try to eat me yet, so.
This room has a different matter, however, as he is in a head-to-head fight with this cat.
Maybe I should have greased him up instead.
I hope this room can take on a cat.
We'll see.
Oops, that's not... That's the wrong thing to put. The cat is dead. As he just...
Cat.
Gun rays it to death with frozen beams.
Cat.
Poor cat. It almost had more than 6 seconds of life in this realm. But alas... Reginald, it is your turn.
Is this a giant subtype creature?
It is not.
It said large, right?
Yeah, it is large, yes. But its subtype is not giant. If anyone has knowledge dungeoneering, however, they may or may not be able to discern certain properties of this creature.
Oh, isn't this... I try to escape. Is that a move action, or is that my full round?
That is your standard if you are grappled. It's you either do something you could normally do with, like, one hand free. You could cast a spell, but it would provoke. Or you could attempt to escape with either escape artist or combat maneuver bonus.
Or if you're feeling really ballsy, you can try and take control of the grapple.
That's true. Yes. I forget we have a new grapple master in the game now.
Yes.
I am good. I am out.
Is that 33?
With the plus 10, you succeed and you slip out of its jaws and plop down in the water before it. You still have your move action.
Is it taking attacks of opportunity?
Correct. And if it were to bite you, it could try and grab you again.
Then I stay where I am.
Okay. Nithyring. Pauline is 15 feet from it. RJ is just beneath its jaw. And you are now 20 feet from it.
Okay.
We had to move one square.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I'm going to... I don't have a whole lot I can do here. I guess I'm going to move... Man, this is not a good battle for me. I'm going to move forward to it to within 10 foot, see if it hits me.
All right. You get 10 feet from it. No counterattack thus far.
Okay. Then I hit it with a meteor hammer.
Alrighty.
And that is... All these stupid macros are broke, right?
So, yep. But all of their bonuses should be accurate within them. For trying to figure out what your total is. You don't have to go recalculate it throughout your sheet.
Oh, it works now.
Aha! Did you just remake it?
Well, that was a yes. I'm gonna roll it and see what happens.
Nothing.
Nope. Okay. R1D 20 plus 6. Okay. 23
hits. It already feels so fucking nice being back on AC.
6 damage.
Alright.
And I stand defensively.
Indeed. It. Mm-hmm. It's gonna roll a check. Okay. It didn't like the taste of the oily gnome in its mouth. So it is going to move up to Nithyrn, which will provoke from both you melee guys, and RJ if you have a melee weapon out.
Nope. I punch him. I had
24 against its AC.
Yep, that hits. You do some damage.
For 7 damage.
Oops.
I pretty much just set up my +1 short spear for this.
Yeah.
I'm going to hit it.
Okay.
That will, because that will automatically proc my my thing if I. No way, that's a 1. God damn it.
That won't proc it.
Nope. Never mind.
Oh no.
Oh no.
So, you punch this thing, but some of those more jaggedy-looking spines that its tentacles have formed into rake across your hand as you come in for the punch, and you take 1 point of strength damage.
Boy.
Yeah, not good.
Now, how many squares did it move to get towards Nith?
Just 1.
So it has a 5-foot reach.
Oh, don't know, but it moved in.
Yeah. But if it moves again, I get to get a second attack.
Mm-hmm.
Indeed. But as Nithyrn throws out the punch, it opens its jaw as she comes with her body toward it, hoping to catch a snack. 24 versus AC.
Misses by 1.
So maybe it's its teeth that rake across your fist and cause that point of strength damage, as it just narrowly misses.
Same time it tried to bite me, I hit it in the tooth.
Yeah, from snatching you in the jaw. They had to move. So that brings it back to Talene.
Alright. Now that I can understand its distancing, it's already past each other. We're already past each other's attack of opportunity range. I'm going to move 1 square close. I'm just going to move right up to it.
Okay.
You should be right real close to it right now.
Yeah, he was 10 feet, but now he's moving directly adjacent.
Yeah, I'm directly adjacent.
RJ, you're kind of like on the side of it.
And then I am going to hit it with my spear. First one, so
yep.
13.
13 will miss.
Those are both bad.
Fizz, you are still safe upon the rooftops. and everyone else is surrounding this thing. Bedroom Wizard, but he just had a cat to vanquish.
I will inspire someone this turn. Abilities.
For our giant.
I will inspire confidence on Tyween.
Tyween, in your buff section, you do have an Inspire Courage buff that I created for you. All you have to do is check that on.
How did I miss this thing? My attack bonus now is plus 9.
Boil them! Mash them! Stick them in a stew!
Calamari.
Let's have calamari.
Uh-huh.
Bread them, bake them, baste them, and I'll stay where I am, safely at a distance.
Alright. Wizrun, having dealt with his cat problem, will come around the corner. And fire off some magic missiles. As these four bolts of force come spiraling in between everybody mashed up in the melee with him and just start slamming into the thing left and right.
Those don't get crit success.
This one doesn't even have an attack roll, so no. Spells that have attack rolls can critically hit. Ray spells can. Reginald! You are adjacent to it on its side.
Reginald moves 5 steps back because that's all he can move.
You cannot 5 foot step in difficult terrain.
Can only move 5 foot. Because it is...
Ah! Your speed is 5. Understood. That will provoke.
That's fine.
Alright.
Didn't he move away from me?
He's large, and he moved 5 feet up. So technically you're on you're still on one of his sides.
Alright, I thought he moved 10 foot to get to Nith, no?
Right. Nithyrn stopped 10 feet from it. When she moved up.
He only had to move 5 feet to be able to attack because it has a 5 foot reach.
Never mind, I don't move.
Alright.
Instead, it will go full defensive.
Okay.
I'm trying to get this thing its attention.
Ithrin.
Alright, well, it's right there in front of me, right?
It is indeed.
Alright, flurry of blows, burn the key, hit it, and intimidate it, do whatever I can to it. First hit. I hope I got this right. Miss.
8 will miss.
I don't know why we can't hit it. That's kind of weird. Okay. That's fine. Hit it again.
A 19 will miss.
Hit it again.
And a 12 will miss.
Alright, I can't hit it.
Not while fighting defensively, likely.
Okay, done.
Alright, it. Talween, you were the last to really stab it for an any amount of damage, and you were right in front of it. So it is going to retaliate in kind. With its full round attack, it is first going to tail slap RJ behind it. 15 versus AC.
Oh.
You duck, slamming your face into the top of the water, RJ, but the tail flies over your head, slams into the side of the building, and you hear this cracking sound, and then it bites at Taween in front of it. 20 versus AC, Taween.
Yeah.
It'll be 8, bludgeoning, piercing, slashing, and then it attempts its grab. It attempts its grab of 30 versus CMD.
Okay.
And since it successfully grapples you, does another 6 points of damage as it immediately begins to constrict you. You're taking a total of 14 damage.
Let's start hitting this thing.
Yeah, now that you got it, now that you got its attention, which is really what I've been waiting for, I'll go ham hock on it. But
indeed, and it grabs. It's got you grappled, Taween, but you're like trying to fend it off with your shield. It's grabbed onto your shield and your whole shield arm. That will bring it to you, Taween. And you are starting off in the grapple. You can make your one-handed melee attack if you'd like, or you could attempt to escape.
Well, as a... So when it bit me, as a...
Mm-hmm.
As a free action right there, I would have done my black blood.
Yep. Ready?
Oh, do I risk the construct damage? Can't bite me. No, I'm just going to give it one... I'm going to give it a good stab. Try to do as much damage to this fucking thing as I can. Mark that I'm grappled. And then... attack. One against its AC.
Hey!
Well, the first one was a 20. The first one was a 27.
Yeah, and that 20.
Oh, 27. That's a 27.
You double clicked again somehow.
Oh goddamn! It's my mouse. I gotta get a new mouse.
Critical hit with the piercing weapon, lodged in the bone. Double damage and 2 bleed. This bleed requires DC 20 to stop.
Would the double damage add into the 1d6 of full damage?
For now, we'll say yes. I don't know how that functions. You'll have to read the ability to double check it. So that is 15 damage from the actual spear, and then 10 more from the cold. And it has bleed 2. As it bites all the way up to your shoulder on your shield arm, and you just jab your spear right in its face, stabbing into one of those multiple eyes as it lets out a screech. It is.
Yes. So how... am I still, like, 35 feet away from it?
You are. I think it's 30 now.
Okay, well... If I'm not 30 feet away, I'll step so that I'm within the 30 feet.
Mm-hmm.
So that I can get my blank bonus. And I will... Well, I'll maintain my... As a free action, I maintain my... Inspire counters on Taween so that he can keep the bonus damage. Mm-hmm. Good job, Taween. Keep slashing, keep thrashing. And then I will fire my crossbow at him.
An 8 will miss.
2-2! Off to the side.
Not even close to the creature.
Yep. That's my ineffective turn, people.
keeping that buff alive.
Yeah.
Wizard. Hey! Nat 20s on a ray attack. And the 12 versus touch does hit as well. So he winds up doing a total of 6 damage to the beast. Hold damage.
That's the card.
Yes. Thank you. It's not often you crit with a spell. Turn around! Double damage and the target can only take one move or standard action on its next round. So it can't do a full action.
That is nice.
Yeah.
That is good.
That's very nice. And it still did the double damage. Bring it to Reginald. You can see it's like being stabbed in the face and the cold damage has it rearing in some strange direction.
Explain what's surrounded him in my blast arrow.
Without hitting anybody. So it's 4 squares. That's 2x2. We'll just say from the 2 northern squares directly above it are Nithian and Tawin, and you are on the back left square adjacent.
I hit it with my bomb without hitting anybody.
Yes, there is a square that you can do that and still directly hit it. Technically, no. It's grappling with Tawin, so Tawin's in its space. You would splash Tawin.
All right then. Since it's grappling, I move away 5 foot.
Okay, and it's in a grapple, so it's not going to choose to end the grapple to get the attack of opportunity.
I take out my crossbow.
All right.
It's my turn.
You can do that as part of your move to take the crossbow out.
Yeah. All right. I fire then.
11 will miss though. Mithrin is eating Tawin.
And I'm sure he doesn't taste good, so I need to help Tywin get out of that beast's mouth. Alright, so...
all that black blood and everything, it can't be good.
Yeah, it cannot be good. Alright, so I am not defensively now.
Yep.
Burn key.
Yep.
Flurry of blows. First, dragon strike, first hit.
Miss.
Miss. Second hit.
Missed.
I'm not going to hit it.
Actually, it's in a grapple. It has minus 2 AC. The 19 hits.
Okay. 7 damage. Let's see if it's intimidated. Where's that intimidate button? There. So it will take intimidate. If it can be intimidated, it's intimidated.
Alrighty.
Probably.
It is going to continue to attempt to eat Tawin.
With only one action.
Can only take a move or a standard. Oh! One moment. Is maintaining the grapple a full round action?
I think he might have to. Remember how we did with the bear? Where the bear had to drop before it could.
Well, that was something else.
Okay, where's my.
It also takes 2 bleed damage.
Yes, thank you. 2 bleed. Okay, it is a standard action to maintain grapple. So, it is going to do that. And constrict. 31 to maintain.
Yep.
Constrict says if a grapple check succeeds, it does constrict damage. And then as part of maintaining the grapple, it gets an auto hit. So with both of those together, that is 16.
Get this thing off me.
Damage as it begins.
My vigor's gone.
As it begins crushing Taween in its jaw. It's clamped down on your shoulder. You feel something crack in your shoulder, Taween. And it is your
turn. Scream out!
Oh god. This isn't good. Get this thing off me! I didn't think it would get two attacks on me if it...
Yep, I went and clarified what Constrict said. And the Constrict monster ability says if it ever succeeds a grapple check to initiate or maintain, it does the Constrict damage. And that's separate from the attack it gets as part of its grapple for keeping grappled. Constrictors are nasty. I have found out.
Yeah, hopefully we'll get to see one in action tomorrow.
I'm sure.
My turn then?
Yes, it is your turn. Every monster has grab now, right? Because it's fun. Grabbing strict.
I'm going to try to break free.
With combat maneuver bonus or escape artist?
Oh. CMB is a plus 8. I'm probably going to do that because.
All right.
My acrobatics is no escape artist is negative 8.
Yeah.
So CMB.
All right.
No.
A 10 does not exceed. That shield is just lodged inside of it. That is your standard action, so that's basically your turn.
Yep.
Fizz!
Get off me.
Where's the passion, Taween?
You're constricted, I can't throw bombs at you.
Heal bombs.
Throw heal bombs.
We'll heal him? Well, maybe. Oh no.
Oh yeah, I see what you're saying. Does it heal the monster too?
We'll see, I guess.
Huh.
Well, how does the thing work?
It changes the bomb into will be cure light wounds if I use a cure light wound potion. 1d8 plus 4. With splash.
It still does splash healing.
So it's not too bad.
Basically like a normal bomb. Well, it still adds your int as well, but...
I'm gonna say this. Next attack... I'm going to be wounded again.
Yeah.
I think Fizz died.
Oh, did he? Disconnect?
No, he's not there.
Oh.
Did the chicken arrive? Is that what I'm smelling?
Yeah.
Alright, I'll go grab that real quick while we're waiting for him to come back. And disable my camera for a minute while I eat.
Sorry.
No problem.
It's got super windy outside and So I had to run around closing windows and move the... Got an umbrella out front now, so...
It is.
Set that down on the ground so it doesn't fly away.
Batten the hatches.
I have been listening, though, so...
Okay, cool. It is your go whenever you are ready.
I died.
Like your laptop died?
No, I'm in a brownout right now.
Oh, like power?
Yeah.
I have power. I have the power. But you're like literally in the community no next right to me. Yeah, it's like really, really windy out there right now. Yeah. Okay. It's raining. At least where we are. Right now, yeah.
As if this battle wasn't hard enough, the monster's taking the power?
Yes. Yeah.
You gotta fight the power. You gotta fight the power, Miguel.
The game forever, then. I need power to play this game.
Oh, there's my lights are flickering.
Oh, God.
Storms.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, it doesn't look like it's gonna... at least it looks like it's gonna blow through pretty quick, so... Okay, well, while Miguel is off and about... I mean, I can do my stuff because I wasn't going to do anything to RJ. I will maintain the inspiration on Tyween. Come on, Tyween. I know you can do it. You can get out of there. You can get out of there. And then I will cast Grease on Tyween to again give him a CMD of plus 10 for 4 minutes, which is like 40 rounds. Right?
Yep.
Spend it on the spell.
Did you just skip my turn?
No, it was still my turn. Or was it not supposed to be my turn?
No, it's your turn.
Okay, yeah. And that's my turn. I'm not moving. I'm not getting closer to this thing. It's still like 30 feet away from me, right? So
yeah. Wizard. Gonna do what Wizard does.
What are these ones he keeps rolling?
It's only a 1d3.
Rolled a crit again.
Fucking crits again, and because he ends it.
It's not a strong spell. The level 0 spell.
At least somebody's rolling good.
Yeah.
That's okay though. Because the critical hit effect is normal damage and the target is reduced as if hit by reduced person for 3 rounds. So it is now medium.
Oh wow.
It's CM.
It's CMB and B just lowered.
B is, yeah, way down. You got advantages and it got disadvantages. That was good timing.
Yeah, and 4 more damage to it from ice. Wow. Spell criticals are cool.
Yeah.
Sometimes you get cats, sometimes you shrink things.
Sometimes you summon a demon from hell.
Indeed. And that would bring it to our storm-blown friend, RJ. For whenever he exists. Hey! It just became your turn.
We'll throw a cure light wound bomb at Tyween.
Okay.
You hit that.
I would hope so.
15 vigor Italian. What's the splash damage on that?
I'm in. Which is 9.
Alright.
That splashed me too then, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
So it heals 9, which removes its bleed.
Yeah. Whatever. Yeah. I got vigor again, so I don't care.
And then it's Nithyarn's turn.
Alright, well, it's still standing there, right?
It is medium now, but yes, it is just standing there.
Alright, so, same routine. Nope. I can't hit it. I'm leaving.
As you swing wildly at the thing, it's not so much that it's dodging out of your way. To flavor its natural armor, it's more so that its tentacles are writhing wildly around it, slapping away attacks here and there as they hit it, or would hit it.
Yeah, it's not DR, because I would bypass DR. Magic for DR, but...
Mm-hmm. It is going to... Let's see. So it reduced in size... So, it gets +1 to that, although it's a... Okay, I just have to straight roll it now. Maintain grapple in that, so that's 15. Okay. This is to maintain the grapple on Tawin.
Yeah.
That is the constrict damage, and that is the...
It's still got a +14?
Damage. Yep.
Wow.
From medium to large only gives +1 CMB and CMD.
There goes that vigor you just gave me. Alright. My turn. I'm going to try to escape again.
Indeed.
Twenty-five.
Yes, that will. As you finally wrench your shield out of its maw.
I am going to... Take.
That is your standard action to escape, by the way.
No, I know.
Okay.
Deciding if I move or not.
Yeah.
What has it done this round? It's not been, it hasn't taken any attacks of opportunity. Could do another attack of opportunity against me. I'm just gonna stand right there then.
Alright.
Not risking the attack of opportunity.
Viz.
Yes. I will maintain my inspiration on Tywin. Great. You're free now. Now whack him in the face! Tywin, whack him in the face! And I will shoot a crossbow bolt at them. If that rolls.
14 will miss. 15 will
14
miss.
14 will miss.
There's a point blank. Yes. Let's see if Wizard can critically Ray of Frost again.
He's our damage. He's our...
The first one misses damage. This time around. But the second one makes contact. And does a little bit of an ice patch on one of its tentacles. would you need if you are alive?
I am alive. Just my monitor that I was using as my second one kind of just keeled over that. Not turning on anymore.
So, I'm no longer grappled, so if you throw a bomb at it, you won't do damage.
It is medium right now, though.
Medium?
Oh, you're right.
That's beside Taween and Neth?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yep.
So you would do damage to us?
The splash, but we gotta kill it.
And I will...
One might say it is looking a little grazed.
I will tell them to back. I'm gonna throw a bomb real quick. Throw it while when you guys are out of range. They'll hold an action to throw a bomb after Nith and Taween are out of range of my bomb.
Okay. Mithrin.
I don't think I was paying attention.
RJ said, get away from it. I'm going to throw a bomb. And held
no,
it
I know. I'm trying to decide whether or not I was watching his lips.
Oh, yeah.
Or yes. Paying attention to the, I guess I caught it.
Ness can't hear.
I could see you swinging your arm back. Getting ready to. But, I think I'm a little bit pissed that I'm not hitting the thing, so... I think I'm going to try... a wave blade... all my attacks with my wave blade.
Okay.
Okay, first one.
That'll hit.
And second one. And third one. Yeah, I can't hit the damn thing, no matter what I do. Alright, that's it. Sorry. I didn't move, so you gotta do what you gotta do.
I held it till you guys move.
Yeah, I know. If I would have moved, there's an attack of opportunity in there as well, so. But whatever.
Alright. On its turn, Taween, having slipped from its jaw, is also not pleased with Taween's current taste. And is going to shift its focus yet again toward Nithyrn.
I don't understand why they're rolling so well.
First with the tail slap. Oh, no, it can't. Just a bite at Nithyrn. And a 10 will miss.
Yep.
Oh, of course you get the low roll. They're rolling like 30s against me.
Taween.
Well,
hey man. Don't hate the player, hate the dice.
Well, it's more interested in this now. Still could get an attack of opportunity against him. I'm just going to stab it, though.
Okay.
What did it do last turn?
It bit.
No, I'm good. I don't get my... It attacked Nith, not me, so I don't get my black blood thing.
Mm-hmm.
So, attack. Miss. Fuck, we are just all rolling low. I'm getting a plus
8. I'm rolling 18s and missing.
Oh.
I don't know what's going on with my roll is the problem. 18 plus 5, and it came out as a 21. So I'm screwed up with this thing.
No, that's a 16 plus 5.
Yeah.
Rolling 1d20 CS 18 plus 5 total. Da 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 da. 16 slash. Okay, there you go.
Yeah, it says 18 plus 5 for all of them. So I don't think that 18 plus 5 is. I think that's all your right. Crit range. Your crit range, yeah. I think, is 18.
All right, so 10, a 6.
Oh, yeah, you rolled a 16.
16.
A 6. Okay. And a 10.
Okay.
Yeah, we're just rolling bad. I rolled a 5 right there. I get a plus 7 to my fucking attack.
It is.
Yes. Indeed. Ugh. I guess I'll just shoot my crossbow at him again.
Alright. 12 will miss.
Many arrows are on the ground behind the beast in the water.
Just floating and bobbing around nearby.
Oh yeah, that's right. They're made out of wood. So yeah. Floating around.
Two more finger guns from around the corner. Slow him into the beast.
I blew a fuse. Where?
Jeez. Reginald, your hold held action never triggers, and it's back to your turn.
Back to my turn.
Just throw it.
So I noticed that you really don't want to move. The question. Probably. Damn it. I throw a bomb.
All right.
I have good reflex.
We will get hurt. He has no vigor.
I am a touch.
12 barely hits it versus touch.
DC 16 reflex.
You did throw a bomb?
Yes.
Yep, reflex save, Tawin.
Missed me.
If I die here, it's all RJ's fault.
That means you take 3 damage, Mithrin.
No, I take 0.
Oh, yeah, you've got evasion.
Nope, 19 reflex.
Tawin, however... Oh, the double click! You take 3 damage, Tawin.
I think I definitely blew a fuse somewhere. I don't know why my router is on, though.
As the fire splashes around the medium-sized beast onto both of you, Nithir, and it is your turn.
Okay, let's see, 1, 2, 3, so...
Mind if we finish this off after this fight, Bar?
Okay.
I'll figure out what the hell's happening with power right now.
That one.
Many nat ones, friend.
You get the card, the pointy end goes there, and you take 1 point of constitution damage. As you somehow, through your dancing, manage to slice yourself.
Slice and dice yourself.
It. Like your roll. 1, 2, 3 in my mind. All right. Taween, it turns away from you.
It was attacked Nith last time anyways.
It did. And it turns away from Nithirin as well. As it
come
is
me, bro.
Not happy about the fire-throwing maniac. Both of you are going to get attacks of opportunity as it steps towards RJ. It's only moving one square. But you both get it.
Please hit this damn thing. 25. 12 damage.
Wham, as you slam into the beast. Nithir, in your attack of opportunity. A 19 hits it. Apparently.
Would technically be flanking with. Well?
You? No.
I don't think we get flanking for attack of opportunities.
You would if you were flanking, but you guys are both generally in front of it still, so. It moves over. And its jaws come down on the RJ. I have to roll it manually. Everything's changed, I forgot.
I mean, you can mouse over the rolls, I think, and look at the bonuses.
That's true. That's true. We're just going to do what Fizz said. I'll just manually adjust the one roll. So that's a 23 versus AC.
That would hit. I'm you, Fizz.
7 damage. And then it attempts the grab of a 20 versus CMD.
It's always going to grab me.
Okay. No. And then...
You still have plus 10.
It does not grab me.
It still does the 8. The 7 bite damage. And it unsuccessfully grabs you.
Grabs it. It does grab him or doesn't grab him?
Does not.
Okay.
His CMD is right now is 20, 25.
Yeah, that's a good use of grease. No doubt about it.
Yeah. Tawin.
It is your turn. I mean, it's still in my attack range, so I'm just going to stab it.
Uh-huh.
And miss. How? Plus 12. Plus 9. I just have to roll like a fucking 11 and I hit this thing.
Fizz. It's looking a little wobbly. It's having a hard time closing down on RJ.
Excellent. Then I will, you know, stick him again, Tommy. Stick him again. To maintain,
I'm trying.
Stick him harder, then.
Things wiggly.
Just do it. Do it. And I am going to expend another spell slot to cast Ear Piercing Scream.
Hey.
So it's the... Oh, it rolled the dice right in there. Cool.
Yeah, I added that at the end.
Cool.
Fortitude partial for the days.
Yes.
All right. It is dazed for one round. Takes 4 points of damage.
Sonic damage, if that matters. Scenic! And I will actually, I don't know, if I can somehow start moving to sort of, like, circle this thing to maybe try and get behind it.
If you keep going down the buildings, you more or less will kind of get behind it. You will have to do a building hop, though.
Yeah, I would have been doing 5 foot steps to get flanking and stuff, but we're in
the difficult terrain.
Yeah. So yeah, I'll do that and I'll try
acrobatics.
Acrobatics. 21.
Do you have a vacuum, Navar?
No, I don't have the vacuum in here. I was looking for it the other day.
Yeah.
I can't find it.
Vacuum thief.
Yeah, she put it. No. She puts things away and then doesn't know where they're at. So.
Yeah, it wasn't in the closet a couple days ago when I looked for it.
Yep.
Mind off.
Yeah. Oh, Danny can't put the same thing in the same place twice ever.
That just makes too much sense.
Yeah. Filipino thing.
You're all fighting it, RJ. It's bearing down on you, and from around the corner. Wizard cocks those rays of ice and fires, but well, the first one hits and deals 3 damage. As it he shoots it square in the face, in between all of the little eyes where they start to meet, and with a loud gurgling sound, it slumps into the water.
The wizard kills him.
Yeah.
with a ray of frost. See, I was gonna shove a bomb down its throat.
It's almost as bad as when one of fucking Azir's squirrels killed something.
Oh. And you can see behind the battle on the wall of the dome the last of the intrusions closing around, reforming into their pure white color as the beast itself begins to bubble and roil over, and it almost dissolves into the water itself. And all goes quiet.
at Aween and make my way towards him, creating a heal bomb.
Yeah, Tywin is... One sec, let me... Now I'm no longer... Rage and... large person would go away. Inspired Courage would go away.
Indeed.
That, do that correct.
But all you have to do is uncheck those right. boxes and everything reverts.
Is it my turn?
The wizard killed it with a ray of frost.
Ah, okay. Good. Glad somebody's getting something done.
Alright.
It ain't me. Or Tawin today.
I gave it a couple good stabs. That thing was wiggly.
Wizard comes sloshing up to the water.
I think I hurt myself more than it.
I can't say the same. That thing actually took a couple good bites out of me. I would appreciate some type of healing.
If anyone's hurt, cluster around Tawin, please.
Got it. Is everyone all right up here?
I'll stand by Tawin, I think.
Yeah.
You clamber down the side of the building and hop into the water.
Has anybody seen Lyanna?
She bailed on us.
I'm here. Alright, hold this, Halloween.
Alright.
Give you my bomb.
Brush it in my finger. Is that vigor or wounds?
Technically, this would be vigor.
15 vigor, I'll take it.
Anyone who's around him gets 9 vigor.
I only get, I'm wounded now, but that's fine. What was that thing?
Give me 1 sec, though. I'll treat your wounds right now. I will do treat deadly wound.
So you're stopping here in the water for an hour?
Oh, when we get to a place where I can, that's dry anyways.
Okay.
I don't know, I feel like we need to get out of here.
What perception checks? Also, Tawin, when you asked that question, Wizard says... I've never seen anything like that. It was some sort of aquatic aberration. The way that it formed, the way that it moved, it was unnatural. Purely meat and bone and brawn, though. It didn't seem to possess any special qualities other than fast movement and raw strength.
We just had... what were we doing again? I'm just so...
Doing those things. Make sure that the dome is up with his help.
Was that the only one that we had to fight?
Is there any more cracks that we can see?
As you look around, you don't see any other fractures in the dome itself. You, however, RJ, see Linenia hobbling down one of the alleys towards you guys. She's limping. You can see part of her shirt is torn, revealing for you, Fizz, a soft shoulder.
Looks like you made out of that one too. Drink these two. Yeah. Give her 2 cure light wounds.
Some sort of monstrosity. I managed to get the tentacles off the wall. As I was collecting myself, this thing came scrambling down the tunnels at me. barely fought it off.
You don't think we could have handled two monsters we had to deal with? Its tentacles came back to life, it seemed. Created a tentacle monster.
Yeah, something similar attacked me.
These two cure light wounds should give you a bit more energy.
To who?
Yeah, Anya.
As you heal her, you see some of the cuts and bite marks somewhat recede upon her. Some of the bruising. Take some time to heal the wounds, but for now, she's passable.
Let me get somewhere drier and safer. I'll treat everybody's wounds. But now it's... It might be best to go back to Sin.
Did the... What does the dome look like? Did you already explain that?
Yeah, the... fissures that were upon its surface receded back and became pure white like the rest of the dome.
Okay.
Looks like we did what we were supposed to. It was quite a fight.
As you all are making your way out of the flooded section and back towards dry land, then a few minutes have passed, 5, maybe 10. You all hear in your minds, "You have all done so well." You have stopped the forces beyond this dome from entering. And as long as this place does not fall to ruin again, it will remain intact for now. But this place will need power yet again. For with no one here to believe in what it stands for, my power will wane. And when that power drains, so too the protection I can provide for this place. Regardless of who you get to come to this place, be sure that they come for the right reasons, that they can supply themselves with food and the things they need to survive in this inhospitable place. Perhaps with time and their aid, things can return to normal here, and the streets can yet again run with the laughter of children and those who know that they protect the world from the powers of this realm. You have all been so dear to me in our journeys. You have shown an old man kindness that many wouldn't even consider. For that, I thank you all. Be wary what you now know, for the knowledge you have carries with it great power. As for the boon that I have given you, use it in your times of great need, in the times where you fear for the lives of yourselves and for your friends. And know that to regain the semblance of that power once expended, purify the Astron you come across. Turn the taint that they hold into power for your own. Only the clear crystals are truly pure. All others hold the taint of another realm's power. Be careful, my friends. And it was a wonderful journey while it lasted. And the voice goes silent.
Guess we should go.
Let's go back. Need to talk to everybody. We need to talk to. What Sin is saying is right. People need to be here.
Bill, we'll have to make sure we finish our promise for Tissin to find someone to live here.
Yes.
People
that can sustain themselves here. I need people to help with. As I look at Lugania, I think that
she looks back and kind of says, well, I suppose we have some things to figure out then, don't we?
But before that, let's onto those boats so I can attend to everybody's wounds. I think everyone's a bit tired right now.
Indeed. I imagine we'll have time to figure things out on the journey back.
Mind if we end here? I have like 1% of my battery left.
Yeah, that's fine if everybody else is fine with that.
Yeah.
A little bit of a short session.
Can't control a storm, can you?
No, we got the big boss fight out of the way, and this was a decent place anyway.
Yeah.
Sort of a transitioning period. So I'll leave it off with this then. As you all regather yourselves, you all gather the things that you found here within the Anchor of Sin, and make your way back to the center of town, where you find your rowboat and the whirlpool no longer raging. The archways that were within the center of that waterway are now glowing with a bright white light. And there's the shimmering mirage of the other side of the portal in the center. You all get on the boat and begin to row yourselves toward it. And that's where we'll pick it up next time.
Cool.
That was a brutal fight.
Oh. Yeah, you thought so?
Trying to kill Taween off again, I see.
That was a pure beef monster. That was a CR7.
Yep.
We lost Miguel.
Before it started,
the battery probably died.
Yeah. He's back. He's trying to stay around.
Trying. Computer just died on me.
Hook up that bicycle generator and get going.
Yeah, start pedaling.
I have power. It's just I think that one of my fuses blew out.
Do you know where your breaker board is?
Yeah, I'm gonna go check.
With back to AC rules, that thing had a 21 AC as its base.
Yeah.
Everyone needs to do touch damage.
Two of you do.
Yeah.
I was just rolling bad.
Oh yeah, you guys are having horrible just die rolls.
Yeah.
Like, I hit a plus 9 to my fucking attack rolls there.
Yeah, it was still around a 50-50 chance for you melee people to hit it.
Oh, a little bit. Not for Mark. Mark had to roll like a 15 or higher.
That's true.
Yeah, 15 or 16.
16.
Wasn't my fight.
No.
And then it had 49 vigor and 70 wounds. That can
through it pretty.
Yeah,
through it pretty well.
You did. That constrict ability was fucking nasty, but the use of grease, holy shit, that was incredible.
Yep, MVP grease.
That kept Tawin alive.
Oh, I think it probably kept RJ alive too, to be honest.
Oh yeah, that thing would
everyone alive.
RJ would have never got out of there.
With a plus 16 to grapple and a 24 CMD, it would have been very hard for you guys to escape that once you got in it.
Yeah, nobody was gonna get out of that. Grease was making you a slippery pig. All of us slippery pigs is the way to do it, no doubt.
MVP.
Yep, big time. You got it, Biz.
Yeah, I don't know if I could have even hit him with arrows if you're